Om Namah Shivaya, my dear students. Today I will explain you that creating a series using lists, and I will show you some programs also, small programs. So for this one, first we have to read, that is creating a series using series with argument. So here we create a series with this series method and with some arguments. So to last day we create an empty series, but today we will create a series with some value and we pass the value as argument. So let's start our class. A series is creating using series method by passing index and data element as the argument to it. The syntax is, look at the syntax, series object equals to pandas dot series data comma index. The data supply to series can be defined from, it can be a sequence, that's mean it can be a list, it can be nd array, it can be scalar value, it can be Python dictionary or mathematical expression or function also. Okay, so in the next page we are creating a series using list, means using a sequence. Like an array, a list is also a one-dimensional data type, but the difference lies in the fact that array contain element of same data type, while a list may contain element of same or different data type. Array is basically a homogeneous data type because array store only same type of value, but list stores same or different type of value. A list can be converted into a series using series method. Okay, so for this one you have to write this one, is import pandas as pd, series object equals to pd dot series data comma your index value, where data can be Python sequence such as a list, dictionary or scalar value. So data is your list, it can be your list, it can be your dictionary or the scalar value, and index is the numeric values display with their respective values. So this indexing is basically their positions, so where the value is stored. So this is your practical implementation tool. Students, write this code in your practical lab copy of this pandas chapters. So here we write, that is import pandas as pd. Next we define panda of a series object name as series 1, or we can define also s1, that is depends on you. Basically you can define variable name according to your choice. Next we write pd dot series, within parentheses we define a list and the value is 10 20 30 40. So after that, if you write print series 1, give an enter, then you will see that this type of answer is coming, and data type it show, that is int 64, that is your default data type. Here we insert only one value, one series of value, but here we can see the two series of value. One is my data value, another is my index value. These are basically my 0, 1, 2, 3 is my indexing value. So this value, this list, if you create a list like this way, 10, 20, 30, 40, it will be in the list, it stored the value in the different indexing positions. The position is always start from 0, that we already know in the list chapter, we read it in class 11. Position is 0, 1, 2, 3, and that's indexing value is showing at here. In the above program, list of integer is converted into Python pandas using series method, but in the output, two columns are displayed. Irrespective of the fact that we have not given any indexing to this element, we are not giving any indexing value at here, we are giving only data value at here. This is I've not given the value. This is because Python pandas, because pandas create a default index and automatically assign that index value from 0 to 3. So if I not define any index value, Python will be given this one automatically, and the default value start from this 0. Next, come to next program. Here we use the range function at here. Write this one also in your computer lab copy. Here we create series of the value using range method. So for this one you have to write import panda as pd series 1 equals to pd dot series range 5. Range, this function is used to create a sequence of the value, and the value should be go up from 0 to up to n minus 1 term. So n value is 5 at here, that means it will be show from 0 to 4. And if you write series 1, give enter, then you can see that this type of sequence is coming here. 0 to 4, these are the my data value, and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are my index value. See, it's my index value and these are my data value. Go to next page. Here it's written as the showing the Python shell window, the output display two columns. The first one display the index value and the second display the value from 0 to 4. The last element display using range function, that is, then the size it should be minus 1. That is, if you define 5, it will be become 5 minus 1. That's 4. And look at that, the same thing, this one. Now here we define a float type of value. The previous program we define a integer type of value, now we define a float type of value. So handling floating point value for generating a series. See, here is written this import panda as pds, pandas as pd, series 1 equals to pd dot series 2, 4, 6, 7.5. And next you write series and give a enter, then we can see this all these 2, 4, 6, look at here, this is 2, 4, 6 are the integer type of value, but 7.5 are the floating point of value. We already read that is series, list can be same type of value, it can hold same type of value, different type of value. So here the values are the different types. These are the integer type of value and this one is the float type of value. So in the output we can see that all the values are come the float type of value, because float, it stored more bytes, float takes more bytes to store our data. So all the integer type of values are converted into float type. Since 7.5, one of the element in the list is a float value, it shall convert the rest of the integer value into float, and hence the result display as a float series. So look at there, it's become a float series, and these are the my indexing positions. Okay, now the next program I'm going to show you a list of value with the indexing. So this program you also have to write your computer lab copy. So here we define import panda as pd series 2 equals to pd series. Now look at here, within the parentheses first I define the value, next comma, next index equals to this one. In the index we define some others list of value also. So when you write series 2, you give an enter sign at here, you give enter, then in the output we will see this. By default it was 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, but right now we are giving indexing value, so that's why it show A, B, C, D, E. So it show A, B, C, D, E, and the corresponding value is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay. So another program is also there that I show you. Suppose you create a series without indexing. So look at this code, import panda as pd series equals to pd dot series 1 2 3 4 5 6. That means by default it show the indexing position 0 1 2 3 4 5, and the corresponding data value is 1 2 3 4 5 6, and the data type is integer 64. Now suppose after this one you want to give your indexing value, suppose you forget to give your indexing value, that's why it show you like this way. Next you can change your indexing value. Here we create a series of value with indexing, but here we change the indexing value name. So for this one, here I write that is series, or here is written series dot index equals to first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, like this. So that's mean the indexing value will be first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So After that, if you write print series, then indexing value, it will be changed. By default, it was 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But right now, it will become 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. And the corresponding data value is this one. So it will be coming in this position. So you can write also this thing in your lab copy. So I hope all of you understand our today's class. Om Namah Shivaya students.